Deputy Louise O'Reilly, please.
Gormaigat, Cian Corla. Tánaiste, the chaos caused by your government is starting to get out of control. Your mismanagement has led to chaos in our justice system, chaos in transport, chaos in governance. But perhaps the most stark and most painful is the chaos in our hospitals. Waiting lists continue to soar. Exhausted and demoralised staff are leaving in droves. And there is a dangerous lack of capacity in our ambulance services. And there has been no let up. There is no let up for the nurse finishing a 12-hour shift, knowing that she has to face back into dealing with the consequence of your mismanagement and chaotic attitude to healthcare. Figures published by the Irish Nurses and Midwives Organisation, and I want to thank them for publishing those figures because they are a very valuable addition to our discourse on health. They inject facts very often which contradict your spin. Those figures show that March 2017 has seen the highest ever level on trolleys since 2006. So, for the benefit of those that haven't heard, that's 9,459. In 2008, it was 4,700. Last month, 9,459 patients were admitted for inpatient care. A decision was taken by a doctor that they needed a bed and there was no bed for them. And I remind you that it is only a matter of a short few years since your colleague, the former minister, James Riley, gave a commitment that never again would we see 569 on trolleys. And in January, you all got surprised by the flu and the figure went to over 600. Now, Tánaiste, I'm a great believer in if something needs to be fixed, we stop and we do that. Clearly, reviews don't work. Committees don't work. Kicking the can down the road, and God knows that's one of your favourite pastimes, does not work. Your winter initiative hasn't worked. The National Treatment Purchase Fund, the practice of giving money into the private sector, crossing your fingers, closing your eyes and hoping that somehow that's going to improve the public service, has not worked and will not work in the long run. People need solutions, Tánaiste. They need solutions that work. And my questions are, will you take the necessary steps to deal with the scale of this crisis? Will you listen to the voices of patients and carers and the workers and their representatives? Will you confirm for our elderly citizens sitting at home in fear that you will not means test the already overstretched home health service and in fact you will increase the number of hours that are available?
Thank you, Deputy. Tánaiste.
Well, this government has been taking action, is taking action, and the Minister for Health has a whole series of initiatives to improve our health service. The first point I would make is it's the highest health budget ever, 14.6 billion, demonstrating the government's commitment to investing the gains from the recovering economy that I spoke about to improving the health services. There is increased demand, as you rightly point out, from a growing and ageing population. And we also clearly have a whole series of new developments in drugs, for example. You've seen the decision that has been taken this week in relation to Orkambi, the very welcome decision to respond to the needs of people who have cystic fibrosis. The Minister met this morning with the INMO. As you know, and it's worth putting this on the record, Deputy, as well, over 80% of nurses voted to accept the WRC recommendation recently, over 80%. Now that, in terms of improving our health service, the key issue is the recruitment of more nurses. And there is an agreement that 1,208, part of that, of those proposals was 1,208 new posts for nurses will be in place by the end of this year, fully funded. fully funded. And both the INMO and the Minister are working to ensure that we have that recruitment, that we have that retention. That's absolutely critical. There's a new Bring Them Home initiative. There's increased supports for nurses who do return. There's further pre-retirement initiatives to ensure that we can retain the nurses that we have. So the Minister and the INMO are agreed on that. The nurses, over 80% of them, are agreed in relation to that. A number of other initiatives I'd point to, Deputy, that have happened. We've seen the increased money that's gone into home care for the very people that you speak about, increased numbers of home care packages, the additional funding of 18.5 million in Budget 2017 to support the development of primary care services. And Deputy, this week, given the funding that we now have for the National Treatment Purchase Fund, over 2,000 people are going to get their appointments that are now possible because that funding is available this week under the National Treatment Purchase Fund. That's real people who need services. And let me point out as well, in relation to the trolley numbers, they're down approximately 5% in the year to date, and for progress is being made, but of course, there are huge challenges. Progress is being made, and there's a decrease on every single day in April compared to the same time last year, except for one day. It ranges from a 3.6 decrease in waiting time down to a 27.7% decrease on another day in terms of numbers. So progress is being made, but there are huge challenges, extra demands on our health services. But obviously, I would totally acknowledge the distress that can be caused and is being caused to patients, their families, and indeed to frontline staff who have been working in extremely difficult circumstances. But a whole range of both budgetary supports and other supports are being made. And for example, this year, an issue that was raised here frequently before, in January and February of this year, we've the lowest level of delayed discharges in recent years.
Thank you, Tom.
So there is progress, but there are huge challenges.
Deputy O'Reilly.
From Agat. Yes, in January, Tánaiste, the numbers on trolleys hit a record level. You're quite fond of setting records. Unfortunately, none of them are very good or useful. You paint a very rosy picture of all the things you'd like to do and all the things you say that are happening. And I wonder, would you like to go down to any of the 409 people waiting on trolleys and tell them about your great plan? Because they can't see. I've already said what you're doing is not working. Clearly there is a crisis in our health service, and yet you all seem more interested in who the next leader of your party is going to be. I think you have your eye off the ball, Tánaiste, and I think your government is letting down the 650,000 people who are on waiting lists. You are letting down the 9,400 people who waited on trolleys in March, and you can't spin this as a good news story, Tánaiste, because it isn't. So do not pat yourself on the back for your so-called achievements, because you have achieved record numbers on trolleys. I'll ask again, will you commit to reopening beds? Will you invest in primary care? And will you recruit the staff necessary? And by that, I mean actually recruit staff, because between December 2016 and January 2017, 168 nurses were lost out of the system. Your recruitment plan is not working.
Thank you. Tánaiste, to conclude.
His focus is entirely on ensuring that these initiatives, which he has announced and is working on, that they have his full focus. Just this morning, as I said to you, the INMO met with him to focus on the very key issue of recruitment and retention. And the plan that has been accepted by the nurses, by over 80% of them, that's important. I'm certainly not complacent in relation to the challenges, and I've said that, and I've acknowledged the distress to any one patient waiting on a trolley. Any one patient is one too many. But clearly, these problems cannot be solved overnight. But what I'm saying to you is that the initiatives and the actions are in place to ensure that we have continuous improvements It's very challenging. We've an increased population, we've an older population, but the bed capacity review is underway and will be completed later this year. The discussions are underway with the GPs in relation to the contracts. That's another important building block towards ensuring that the kind of primary care we want to see in this country is in place, which in turn will lessen the pressures on our acute hospitals. So, as I say, there's no complacency. I understand the distress that's caused to any one patient who's on a trolley, but the government is acting proactively to make a difference and improve our health service on an ongoing basis.